Hi guys and welcome back to the channel. Not so long time ago I have built these two mini LED lights to be used when I record my videos and as well to provide some extra light when I'm making projects. Now the light perform well, but they have a drawback. They require about 12 volts to operate, but this can be easily solved by using a 12 volts power pack. But this as well have a drawback due to the size of it and as well the time it required to charge back the batteries. But I was thinking at one solution. First I was thinking to add some kind of a step up module, so call it boost converter in it and call it the day. But after some thoughts I was thinking why not to make some cable which will contain the step up module in them. Like that it will be more easy to power the light from a typical 5 volts power bank or any SMPS or so call it switch mode power supply. Now the module I will be using it will be based on MT3806. Now the module according to the datasheet it is a high efficiency DC-to-DC boost converter running at about 1.2 MHz and it can sustain a load up to 2 amperes, which for its tiny size is packing a punch and it will be enough for some application and as well it can generate up to 28 volts at the output. And as well I will be using one tiny LED voltmeter which will show the voltage which will be set at the output of the module by using the small variable resistor. By doing so the DIY cable will not be limited just to work on 12 volts. But it can be used to power higher loads as well. Let's start the assembly process by grabbing all the required components and start the assembling of this DIY cable according to this schematic which is now in front of you. The circuit is simple and it basically consists of 4 parts for each cable you will be doing. The connector at the output can be any depending on your setup. In my case I will be using 2.1 mm barrel type connector. After the tiny voltmeter which will show the voltage, after the boost converter and finally the cable which can be any old USB cable you may have lying around. Now the circuit is simple and easy to replicate if needed, so give it a try. First let's take the cable and cut about 10 cm from the other end, which will be at the output when the cable will be done. After we cut the wire, we can solder the wire to the connector and after the wire can be soldered to the boost module. And after we can add a small voltmeter. Now to make the voltmeter to be more easy to see the voltage on it, not just for the camera, but as well when I will be using it, I will be using a piece of brown packing tape, like that the voltmeter can be easily seen in any situation. Now try to keep the assembly straight because at the end we will be covering with heat shrink. This will be more for aesthetic purposes and after the input wire are soldered to the boost converter module, we can test the module by connecting it to a USB power bank or any 5V SMPS power supply. If you are using a power bank, be sure that you will be connecting a load before it because the power bank it will switch itself off due to the reason the boost module on the standby mode it uses very little power. And so in result the power bank it will switch itself off after a while. But let's try with another 5V power supply which kept the output on even at a low current. And with the help of the variable resistor so called trim pot we can set the voltage and let's test it. Now as you can see the power bank it switches itself off due to the high power demand, but this can be cheated, like so, and after the lights will stay on. Now due to the USB tester I am using the result voltage and current draw is not accurate. But anyway, this power bank can supply a lot of power, but still the light is enough for those close shots. Now this cable can be used to power different things as well, like example this will be great for powering my DC-0150 digital oscilloscope. But first the voltage has to be changed from 12 to 9 volts. And after that the oscilloscope work like usually, great. Now like I said this cable can be used to power high loads as well. As example I have this computer monitor which I have fixed recently, but it requires about 19 volts to operate. So let's adjust the voltage on the module to about 19.3 volts. And indeed it's working but it's pulling a lot of current at the input. This is normal, the power of the monitor it's okay. Now it may see that the monitor behave a bit weird. And it has some flickering problem. This is because when it's connecting to a computer, it will draw more power from the USB port. And the fact that, like I said, the USB tester I am using is quite bad. But without it, the monitor works like it should. And as well, this cable can be great for future projects. And here is coming the part where I have to say goodbye. I hope I will see you all in my next video. Till then, have a nice day and thank you very much for watching. See ya!